If you want to use a scale when making music, you don't have to keep looking back and forth trying to figure things out. In this video, you'll find out how to show the scale you choose on the track you're composing in, so you can stick to the scale much easier. Keep watching and you'll learn how. Hey everyone, Jacob Transverse Audio here. Now, if you don't know what a scale is, I've made some videos about them if you'd like to check them out. So there's two ways to get the scale to show up on your piano roll. Let's go over the first way to do this. It's also the one I recommend using. First of all, we're gonna need to enable ghost notes if you haven't already. Go to the options menu on the top left corner of the piano roll and select helpers. Go down to ghost channels and make sure it's turned on. You might also want to disable the option to edit those ghost notes. If it's enabled, you might accidentally change the scale when you're writing your music. Now that the ghost channels are enabled, we can get the scale up and running. You can use any plugin for this, but let's just use Sampler to hold the notes we need, since it doesn't produce any noise by default. Drop your notes into the piano roll, and in this case, we'll be using C minor. To make it easier, you might want to copy the scale up and down an octave so you have some more room to work with. You can use this on any pattern you want by copying and pasting it there as well. To stay on track as you develop your composition, you'll find it helpful to duplicate this down the timeline so you don't have to keep scrolling back. Now when you play notes on the instrument you're using, you can directly reference the notes that belong to the scale. The second way of highlighting a scale to use is by going to Helpers, over to Scale Highlighting, and down to the scale you want to use. In this case, I'll be using the major scale, but as you can see, you can pick the one you like. Go back and select the root note that you want the scale to follow. On the plus side, doing it this way will highlight the root note of the scale you've selected with a darker color on the keyboard. If you want to turn the highlighting off altogether, you can just press Default. Now, this alternative to highlighting a scale might be less work up front, but it comes with a possible confusion and more work later on. By using this method, you'll change how the piano roll highlights notes from black and white to the scale you're using. This carries over to any project you open, so you'll have to change it every time you want to use a scale, like the previous method, and you might have a hard time remembering what scale a project is in. Unless, of course, you leave reminders or some way to know what scale is being used in every project. I hope these two approaches were useful, and if you liked it, subscribe and hit the bell button to stay up to date on more videos we make. And as always, thanks for watching.